You may have images that work fine on a low-resolution desktop monitor, but look terrible on a high DPI display. Not a problem, we'll just save an image with larger dimensions. Our wallaby's a lot happier now. Trouble is, we're now serving a bigger image file to everyone, whether they need it or not, and that's going to result in a terrible experience on a slow network, especially, you know, on a smaller screen with lower resolution. The problem with the plain old image source attribute is that it only gives one URL for one image. What if you want to provide alternative files for the same image so the browser can choose the best option for the viewport size and device capabilities? Source set to the rescue. Here we added a source set attribute to our image element. The syntax here simply means that the browser should choose the higher resolution Wallaby 2x JPEG for a high DPI display, or the lower resolution Wallaby 1x JPEG otherwise. The 1x 2x syntax is called a pixel density descriptor. And if we check from the dev tools using emulation mode for a 1x device, you'll see that only the 1x image has been loaded. Nice wallaby. By the way, I've added a 1x descriptor after the 1x image source, but that's the default. Different screens have different pixel densities, more or less dots of color per square inch, the physical pixels. And the more dots per inch, the higher resolution the display and the greater the pixel density. So standard laptop and desktop monitors are regarded as being 1x displays, whereas devices such as high-spec laptops and phones can be 2x or more. Every day there are more and more new screens with different pixel densities. You can check this from the DevTools console by looking at the device pixel ratio for your display. Here, the device pixel ratio is 1.75 for my monitor, and now I'm using remote debugging for my phone with the DevTools, and you can see that the device pixel ratio there is 3. You can find out more about pixel density by following the link below the video. What if the browser doesn't support the source set attribute? That's not a problem. The source set attribute is ignored and the image is loaded in the usual way using the source attribute. Here I'm opening the page in Firefox where the source set attribute is still behind a flag, and you'll see the 1x version is downloaded, the default from the source attribute. Turn on the flag, reload, and presto! You can see the source set attribute in action. Source set can also be used with width units. For a browser, there's a catch-22 when it comes to choosing which image to download. The browser needs to know the dimensions of each image, but it can't know that without downloading each image to check. Enter the mighty W unit. The W unit tells the browser the width of each image, thereby enabling the browser to choose the right image to retrieve depending on the screen pixel density and the viewport size. Think about it. If you have a browser window sized at, say, 500 pixels wide on a 2x display, an image 1,000 pixels wide, that's 2 times 500, will be adequate for any display size in that window. The point is that we're enabling the browser to make the right choice of image, since at runtime the browser knows the screen size and pixel density, but not the image size. Later, you'll see how to work with image display sizes that are less than the full width of the viewport. Now, you might be wondering, why width and not height? Well, width covers most use cases, but there has been some discussion of introducing an H unit. And for the responsive obsessives among you, follow the link below the video.